We can now continue with our outside frame. So for the outside frame, we have these flower petals with the curvy veins on top. So what I've done is, in my previous design, is I raised up these curvy designs so that they sit on top of the petals. Then we raise up the petals, and then these detailed leafy patterns we're going to do in an etching design. So first we're going to start with raising up each of these central petals designs, and then we'll come back and raise up the central petal. So back onto our lino. I'm first going to do, on the front of my pewter, the curvy design outline, and then raise them up. They are spaced close to each other, so I'm going to do them one at a time on each petal. And then we can flatten. Then we can define with our Teflon tool, and with the defining with the Teflon tool, we can get into these tiny little spaces here again. Okay, so I'm going to lift them up a little bit from the back, but not too much. So with a very soft pressure, After we have added some extra height from the back, we can go back to the front of our pewter and flatten around our design. Okay, so now we can continue in the same manner as we did the first design on our leaf. We're going to do the second curvy pattern as well. Back onto our liner, we repeat exactly the same process. We first do the outlines of our curves on each one of the central patterns, and then we come back to flatten. And then we can flatten from the front on our hard surface. Now we can raise our second designs also from the back. So we go back to our soft surface. We turn our pewter upside down, and using our paper stump, we can add a little bit of height from the back. And then we can flatten again from the front. So we turn our pewter face up again and repeat our flattening process. After we've finished defining, we can then go and lift up our entire fat petal. There we go. So now we've finished lifting up our first layer, so we can now lift up the entire flower petal from the front of our pewter on our lining. So we're now going to draw the outline. And then we can flatten from the front. We remove our liner and we flatten with our paper stump. Thank you. After we finish defining, we're going to lift up our first petal a little bit from the back. So we're going to turn our pewter upside down. We're going to place it on our soft surface. And then I'm going to work out my design with my hands. I'm not going to use my paper stump because I don't want to destroy the shapes. So I'm going to use my hands to slightly bring out that design. And I'm concentrating more in the center so that I get a nice dome shape. After I've raised up each one of them, I'm going to take my paper stump and I'm just going to redefine my raised areas on the inside. So I'm going to take the paper stump and just redefine the raised areas. Then we can flatten it from the front again. Now we can continue with the two leaves that sits on either side of our central leaf. So first we have to lift up the design that is on the top layer, and then we can lift up the petal itself. So back onto the liner, I'm now going to do all of these ones at the same time and then do the lift. now I'm going to use the different tool to get into these tiny little details. There we go. So I've now done each one of these, and we can now lift up the rest of our leafy petals. I've received a lot of height from doing it from the front. So if you still want to, you can now do exactly the same principle as before. Turn it upside down, put it on your soft surface, add a little bit of extra height from the back. I'm pretty happy with my height, so I'm just going to leave it as it is. So I'm immediately going to do my outline. So back onto the lino with our Teflon tip tool, I'm going to trace the outline of all of my leaves. And now we can flatten from the front. So we remove the liner and we flatten with our paper stamp. Now I'm going to lift up the side petals from the back. And I'm getting going to lift them up by using my hands first. And then I'm going to redefine the shapes from the back with the paper stuff. There we go. So now we can continue, and we're going to lift up our external frame around our entire design. So we're going to go back onto our lino. And from the front, we're going to do both the inside and the outside line. There we go, and now we can flatten both on the inside and the outside of our frame. And now we can define on both sides of our raised area. And I'm going to use my papers by different tool to flatten the areas in between the leaves. And then I can define. There we go. So I'm not going to lift it up from the back at the moment. We're first going to finish the etching design on our background, and then we're going to do the lifting up of the final frame so that we can add a little bit of height in this area. But for now, we need this area to be fully flat in order to do our etching design.